The 2016 presidential race just got a lot more interesting with Donald Trump having a clear victory in last night's Indiana primary, making Ted Cruz not only elbow his wife in the head, but also drop out officially out of the race. This is nothing new because we saw how many supporters were actually coming out to the Ted Cruz's events, and it wasn't many at all. Glenn Beck even went as far as to say that he would be on suicide watch if Ted Cruz loses Indiana, and now the poor man is faced first in Cheetos in publicity stunts because he lost 40 members of his staff going full out in support of Ted Cruz. And now with the campaign over, just like Glenn Beck's career, we have John Kasich announcing within members of his own team that he soon will be suspending his presidential campaign as well. Now with this happening, Trump is the unofficial nominee for the Republicans in the 2016 presidential race. And obviously this will have huge ramifications politically, breaking up not only the Republican Party, who even members of are saying that they would vote for Hillary Clinton. Now, this is also having a dramatic effect on the Democratic presidential race, with Bernie Sanders supporters saying that Hillary Clinton needs to drop out right now since the Republicans have a candidate because of the revelations that are going to come out from the FBI investigation against her. Hillary Clinton's team is also saying the same thing, saying it's time for Bernie Sanders to just drop out. He needs to stop attacking Hillary Clinton before he helps Donald Trump become president. Now, of course, everyone here is playing politics, and Bernie Sanders, whose whole career, whose whole life was about politics, his first job was at 40, I believe, being a politician, working for politics. Bernie Sanders knows how to play politics, and he even said himself he would certainly support Hillary Clinton when she wins the Democratic nomination, and you could expect him to make that decision within the next few weeks because he will say anything, and with his new youth vote, he is galvanizing people officially to support Hillary Clinton because that's what he has been doing from the very beginning, not being critical of Hillary Clinton's scandals at all. He has been going extremely soft at her. And again, these politicians, this presidential race is all about just saying whatever the American people want to hear in order to get their vote. And the perfect person who does that is Hillary Clinton, who was on an African-American radio show in New York City. And in order to galvanize the African-American vote for her, she said that she carries hot sauce with her everywhere she goes. Obviously, just saying anything, being incredulous, just being so ignorant as to think that the American public will vote for her. African-Americans will vote for her because she has hot sauce with her everywhere she goes. And now the whole Hillary Clinton campaign staff is ordering and carrying hot sauce in order to prove that Hillary Clinton wasn't lying in any way, shape, or form. But again, people, this is just politics. This is just an election. Politicians will say anything to get elected. And of course, this is nothing new, obviously, with Donald Trump as well, who has told news organizations and also his supporters during his speeches that he would be a lot different if he became president. See, Donald Trump, unlike Hillary Clinton, who just outright lies to your face, Donald Trump will tell you, yeah, this is all politics. I'm going to be completely different when I do become president, and I will not enact some of the policies that I said I would. He says this publicly. Now, with this huge breaking news, with Donald Trump being the clear nominee for the Republicans, people are expecting just clear outright rioting for Cleveland's RNC this July. And of course, new reports are coming out proving that U.S. law enforcement is actually preparing for riots on a national scale because of social justice warriors, because of the pro-immigration groups and Black Lives Matter activists who have already been clashing violently with Donald Trump supporters. You can only imagine what will happen at the RNC in July of this year when Donald Trump is assumed the nomination by the Republican Party to run against criminal Hillary Rodham Clinton. Obviously, Clinton rigging the game in her favor is set to be the presidential nominee for the Democratic side. This leaves the 2016 election between an egotistical celebrity with daddy issues versus a criminal psychopath politician that has brought pain and suffering all around the world. This will be an extremely interesting election, especially with Donald Trump not pulling any punches. He went after Ted Cruz's father for even helping out the assassination of John F. Kennedy. There's actually a picture of Ted Cruz's father, Rafael Cruz, with Lee Harvey Oswald. And because of this, Donald Trump made it an issue. You could only imagine what Donald Trump will have to say against Hillary Clinton. But obviously, expect Donald Trump to become more moderate, more in the middle, less of a right winger, and more centrist in this election because, as he says in his own words, he is playing politics. And when he does play politics, you could only imagine what's going to happen. Of course, politicians will say anything to get elected, and that's exactly what we're seeing here. And now with this huge political shift on the Republican side, this will be one of the most interesting elections in our lifetime. Subscribe. Don't forget to support us on Patreon. We're going to be covering the election and a lot more interesting news here on youtube.com/wearechange. Subscribe.